Welcome to the subject 17 CV 752, prefabricated structures. I, Professor R. B. Tilaganji, Department of Civil Engineering, AITM, Belagavi, going to give you related to the syllabus content of prefabricated structures. Is a kind of new structure. We have learned related to RCC, we are going to learn related to steel structures. We have even seen how RCC is prepared. We have even seen what is the steel structures are of, how the steel structures are, how much huge sizes are there, and RCC structures, how they are transferred. We are also going to see what kind of new structures are available. This prefabricated structure is something of new kind. So let us get into what is in detail syllabus for the particular semester. Get into the syllabus. Welcome. Details of syllabus. Module 1 is introduction about prefabricated structures. Module 1 will give us in detail about the what is known as prefabricated structure, how it is separate or different from RCC structure or from steel structure, and how is the upcoming future for the prefabricated structures. Module 2, about prefabricated components. There are the similar components. We may see the components are there present for RCC also. We bifurcate the components such as foundation, such as column, plinth, beam, lintel, slab, all like this. So some components will be there in prefabricators. Those will be studied in module number 2. Module 3 relates to what are the design principles, how the design is going to carried out, what are the main factors we are going to consider in module number 3 will be given. Module number 4, joint in structural members. When this comes, joint in structural members, and related to the word prefabricated, the name itself, pre is already, it's already done. Pre means already. Fabricated what? We usually prepare one steel section as a prefabricated. So that prefabrications we have to consider. Means already prepared. How we are going to prepare, that will be considered. We will be telling you. I will be telling you. What joint connections, that will be dealt in module number 4. Coming to module number 5. Design of the prefabricated structures for abnormal loads. Abnormal loads means what? We are going to consider something called as industrial loads, earthquake loads, wind loads. If they are there, then we will consider some more also. Like this, the syllabus in small brief, detail of this syllabus into the things. Module 1. So module 1 is introduction about prefabricated structures. Why is the need for prefabrication nowadays? Why it is more needed? How it is different from the conventional method of construction? Reasons why we are going to opt for prefabrication? Is it more necessary in this era? Is it more necessary in the future days? Like that, what are the needs? Then comes principle, materials. What are the principles? How it will be taken into consideration? Material. Is there any different material for the prefabrication, or it is as the same conventional material? We are making it into something new type, preparing it into a new part. Modular coordination. What is this modular coordination? Standardization. What standards we are going to use for prefabrication? Production systems. Systems of production. How the systems are there for preparing the production? What is transportation? What is erection? how we are going to transport the prefabricated material. We are not going to transfer the prefabricated material into a small type of vehicles. The huge vehicles are needed. If a huge amount or huge size of section is there, huge size of beam is there, huge size of slab is there. Erection, how we are going to erect them, whether with the help of skilled labors, unskilled labors, or machineries, or something huge machineries are required to erection. This all comes under part of module 2 about prefabricated components. In prefabricated components, what we are going to learn? Behavior of structural components, how the structural components are going to behave. Large panel construction, whether is it possible, imagine the thing, whether it is possible to get the large panel construction, construction of roof and floor slabs, possibilities or not possibilities. Prefabricated is the new thing for us. So new thing we have to go into deep and understand whether it is more useful in our future life, whether we can make this with the future wall, panel, column, shear walls, everything are prepared. Now everything will be prefabricated, but how, material is what? That will be all going to give you in detail in module number. Coming to module number 3, prefabricated design principles. Disinuiting of structures, we are going to disinuit. Design of a cross section based on efficiency of material use. Based on the material efficiency, in conventional method, we were just trying to find out the properties of material, not the efficiency. Now the efficiency of material come into account. Problems in the design cause of flexibility, because of joint flexibility. Joint, how much flexible they are. We are able to see some rigid joints are there. Now whatever the normal constructions are there, they are all rigid. Flexibility is more important nowadays. Allowance for joint deformation, whether we are providing something joint deformation. If some building collapses or whole building collapses, if a beam cracks, we have to remove beam, as well as if when we are removing the beam, we will get also dismantle the slab, we will dismantle the wall, we will dismantle the column. But in this prefabricated, it is not like that. That all will be dealt in module number. Module number 4, joint in structural members. So structural members are what? Slab, beam, column, foundation, plinth beam, lintel, these all are called as structural members. Even sometimes wall is a structural member, sometimes. Because if we take a RCC into consideration for wall, it is a structural member. Joints for different structural constructions, how we are going to do it. Dimensions and detailing. Dimensions are perfect, needs to be perfect. Detailing, drawings are prepared in the detail. Design of expansion joints, some expansions will be taking place if we are making two separate members to join each other, it will be having expansion. Because of why it is expansion? Expansion is because of contraction and expansion, because of temperature variation, because of the temperature variation, because of the load variation, design expansion joints will be there. How we have to maintain those expansion joints? If we maintain huge expansion joints, there will be a water percolation, leakages. If we maintain small expansion joints, then the structure may get collapsed due to the loading pattern or temperature variations. That all will be dealt in the module number 4. Module 5, progressive collapse. So design for abnormal loads it is. What is progressive collapse? Sudden collapse. Why? What code provisions are provided? Equivalent design loads for abnormal effects of earthquake, cyclones, important and avoidance of progressive collapse. After all the 5 modules, what we are able to find, what this particular subject is going to give us. Here are the outcomes after the particular subject explaining the concept of prefabricated structures. we will summarize some components of prefabricated structures such that we can use them in the future. We are able to interpret disseminating of prefabricated structures, solve some problems related to construction or structural joints, some relative progressive collapse and its importance. So this whole subject by the university is again going to have continuous evaluation of 40 marks and semester end examination of 60 marks. So here the theoretical more and conceptual with figures are required in this subject. So we need to understand what is the subject. We have to put our small part of imagination to understand the subject. So the details will all be provided to you with the videos. The same part of videos, you can use them as the notes. You can use them as a preparing for your continuous internal evaluation or semester end examinations. This all will be helping for you to understand the subject prefabricated structure. A very new subject, interesting subject. So let us not wait too much and get into the subject. Welcome. Thank you for understanding. See you in the next video. Have a thumbs up for this. Thank you so much.